Hey everybody, it's Tammy from SketchUp for Interior Designers, and I am back for part two of redesigning this little nook in our bedroom area on the SketchUp for iPad app. Let's dive in.
In part one, we drew the walls and the windows. Now we're going to add a floor. So I'm going to grab my line tool on the left and hard press on one corner, hover over another corner to create a point of inference, hard press, and hard press to close the shape. Now I'm going to choose the select tool, triple click 1, 2, 3, and make it a group. It's the group of blocks in the lower middle toolbar there. Now that it's a group, I can draw a desk right over the top of it without it affecting the wall group. So I'm going to orbit to get to a good place so that I can see both interior walls, and I'm going to grab my rectangle tool. Hard press in the corner, and I'm just going to draw it willy-nilly, kind of at any height that looks good right now. I'll be a little more precise in a moment. Push pull, and I'm going to pull it out 2 feet. And then back to my select tool, I can triple click, make it a group. Now I can move it into place. I'm choosing to drop it down to the floor and then move it up to 30 inches so that the top of it is 30 inches off the floor. Now I can select it and I'm going to put it on a tag, and I'm going to call that tag option 1. I'm just going to write it out. I don't have it connected to my keyboard, so I need to play with this a bit and make sure that it says option 1. I'm just going to spell it out using my pencil. So here we go, opt 1. Okay, that added the tag, but now I need to tag it. So I'm going to swipe from right to left with it selected. Now it should be tagged to option 1, and we can see that in the entity info panel above. And when I check and uncheck the eyeball icon, it should become visible and invisible. The tags control the visibility of that. Now I'm going to add an option 2 on the opposite wall. I'm going to draw a rectangle, just willy-nilly, rectangle tool, and then push pull tool, and I'll pull that out 2 feet again. Now I need to group that together, so I'll hit the select tool, triple click, make it a group, those blocks again. Now again, I like to just drop it to the floor and then bring it back up so that the tabletop is at 42 inches, because this is going to be a standing desk height. And it's a bit too thick, so I'm going to double click into that group and bring it back up just a bit from the bottom up. All right, I'm happy with the way that looks. I can select it. And I'm going to put it on an option 2. So I will add an option, add a tag, and I'm going to call it opt 2. Oh, I got to cross out tag. And then click OK. Now that I have that tag added, I need to tag it to option 2, and I'll swipe from left to right, attributing that to that tag. All right, so now I can toggle between the two, turning off option 1 in the tags panel and leaving option 2 on. And I'm going to add a few things from the 3D warehouse. I'm going to add a desk chair so that I can attribute these to the different options as well. Search desk chair, look for one that looks good. I'm happy with that one. I'll download it directly into the model and orbit to the top so that I can use the move rotate option here. Put that into place, and that one's going to be my option 1 chair. All right, with that selected, I'm going to swipe from right to left so that it now attributes to option 1. Let's find another chair. This one's going to be a drafting style chair because it's our standing height desk. Happy with that one, so I'll download it into the model. Now when I move my cursor, it appears in the model, and I can rotate it from the top here using the move tool, which is already activated when I bring something in from the 3D warehouse. I'm going to attribute that to option 2. Swipe from right to left, and you can see as I toggle those two off, the two options are coordinating with my tags. Now, let's add some textures. Currently, there is carpet wall to wall in the bedroom, but I'd like to add just a little area of hardwood flooring. So I'm going to hit my select tool, double click into the wall group, and grab my line tool and section off an area just for the wood flooring so that I can separate that out from the carpet. It will go underneath the desks here. So I'll make sure that I am double clicked into the correct group and it goes into the space underneath the desks. Now let's go over to our materials panel and click on the 3D Warehouse logo so that we can search for materials. In the search area, I'm going to type wood and then search. And I'll look for a wood flooring texture that I like. I'll click on the thumbnail and then click on show more details, then materials, and I can download it directly from that model. Choose it from my material panel and apply it to the flooring area. I think that this material, now that I see it, is better suited for the desks. So I'm going to undo that, leaving the swatch in my materials panel, and I'll bring back both of my desks, turning on both tags, option one and option two. Now I'm going to double click into the option one block and apply the material to the sides. Same thing with option two, select, double click there, triple click and apply it. Now this one is oriented incorrectly, so I would like the grain to flow the other way. So I'm going to click on the little checkerboard icon that will allow me to adjust the texture, and I'll use the green pin to flip that texture and shrink it a bit. All right, now I'm happy with that. I'll go back to my select tool. Now I'd like to look for wood flooring again for my flooring area. So back to the 3D Warehouse area of the materials panel and search for wood. Happy with that one. Do see more details. And to the materials and download. Apply it directly to the flooring area, and I can see that it's not quite repeating very well. So I'll undo that, two finger tap, and head back to the 3D Warehouse. I'll search again. Hopefully, third time's a charm. I'm going to look at this palette of wood here, see more details, go to the materials area, and download one of the options. I think this one's going to be a winner, and I'll apply it directly to the flooring area. I'm happy with that. I'm going to go back to texture position, little checkerboard, and scale it up a bit. Now I'll turn back my options and look at the contrast of the woods together. I think I'm happy with that. That concludes part two, and coming up soon in part three, we're going to continue to add details to this space, like shutters, adding more textures, scenes, shadows. We're really going to work on composing this space. So I will see you soon for part three.